In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world.
For our goodnight message on this Sunday, the 26th of March 2023, broadcasting from the Salesian community of the Sacred Heart in Lusaka, Zambia, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this strengthening and inspiring message in line with the Word of God for today, entitled Lessons from the Raising of Lazarus.
Ancient words, ever true, changing me and changing you. We have come before the gods, oh, let the ancient words impart.
Today we add another lengthy passage from John chapter 11, verse 1 to 45, the last of the seven signs in the Gospel of John. It was the healing of Lazarus. And being the fifth Sunday, we are done with these remote preparations. Come next Sunday, we have Palm Sunday. And we are reminded today that God never comes late for anything. He is never late. He never overlooks anything that we go through. It may seem like he is not attentive, but he will come through in his own time. Look at the experience of the two sisters, Martha and Mary. They send a message to Jesus. That is a prayer. Your friend whom you love is sick. And definitely they expected him to attend to that friend, but it never happened as they expected it to. Jesus took his time, and he allowed Lazarus to die. Don't you hate it when God doesn't do what you think he should? I'm sure most of us at one time in life have run into a situation and thought, how could God have allowed that to happen? That is what Martha and Mary were thinking when Jesus finally arrived 4 days after Lazarus' death. Both of the sisters questioned Jesus upon his arrival, saying, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. In their hearts, they were full of disappointment with God. Jesus had healed so many others. Why now did he not heal his own friend? How could Jesus have let them down like this? The sisters loved Jesus and believed in him, but were confused by his lack of action. Jesus told Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. John chapter 11 verse 25 and verse 26. This quote from Jesus is a cornerstone of Christian theology and doctrine. Good doctrine and theology were not helping the disappointment and confusion to fade away from these grief-stricken women, though. Then Jesus, the resurrection and the life, stepped up to the tomb and called forth Lazarus from the realm of the dead. Jesus' statement, I'm the resurrection and the life, along with his power to raise Lazarus from the dead, teaches that everything the Bible has to say about heaven, hell, and the promise of eternal life is wrapped up in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. He holds eternity in his hands, so he alone should be trusted with our eternity. The raising of Lazarus teaches us another lesson. When God seems to be doing nothing, he may be doing more than you could ever imagine. Jesus had declared that Lazarus' sickness was for the glory of God. Jesus knew God would be totally glorified in the situation at hand. When Lazarus died, Jesus was just getting started. He used Lazarus' situation to bring the utmost glory to his Father. No, he didn't do what we were expecting. heal Lazarus, he did something better. I know there will be times in the future when God doesn't do what I expect or think he should do. I know in every situation, however, he can and will bring greater glory to himself. If he doesn't do what I think he should, it is very probable that God has something better in mind. Are you dealing with disappointment right now? Has God acted in a way that you would not have expected? Take heart, my brother. Take heart, my sister. Take heart, my friend. Jesus is the resurrection and the life. He can breathe life into any situation you are dealing with. Entrust your situation to God. Then ask God to use your circumstances for his honor and glory. Entreat him to bring forth the greatest glory possible in your life and situation. And then watch out to see what God does. It may seem like he is doing nothing at the moment, but he may be doing more than you could ever imagine. If you don't believe me, just ask Lazarus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.